In order to understand why we would choose virtual production, let's first take a look at exactly what virtual production is. Netflix maintains a broad definition of virtual production that leverages real-time technologies as a means towards creative problem-solving and an approach to production that connects all parts of the process from pre-pro all the way through post. So what are these real-time technologies? To show you, we'll explore a few of the most popular virtual production techniques being used today.
One of the most fascinating things about virtual production is that you are bringing the power back to the hands of the creator. That's something that's not new. In the early days of filmmaking, the creatives, they did have rear projection and they were making the shots, the composition, everything was happening on the day. So that's just exactly what we're doing today, but with high-end technology. Technology has evolved, but the techniques, the tricks that filmmakers have embedded in their brains, that's what makes the magic and makes all those shoots that we see being as beautiful as they can.
Imagine traveling to any location without leaving the comfort of a soundstage. World capture is one of the most common techniques used in virtual production. This is the process of capturing a scene's location using LiDAR scanning and building the digital environment using a real-time game engine. World capture allows filmmakers to transport their characters to any location around the globe.
Action!
We'd all love to be able to preview a complex sequence before a single frame is shot. Filmmakers have historically planned out complex sequences using storyboards or iterative layout or pre-visualization rounds, which means laying a scene out shot by shot. It can take a long time to get right. Introducing Realtime Visualization. It makes this process faster, more immersive, and more accessible, and uses much cooler tech. We're shifting the conversation from fix it in post to plan it in pre. Before the camera rolls, we engage the visualization team. They help to create 3D worlds inside game engines to visualize the director's intent. You can explore this world through a monitor, using your iPad as a camera, or even go into the 3D world to explore using VR headsets. You can work out timing decisions and blocking, even try out different lenses in real time and create full sequences or edits. When creatives can preview the final product before production, time is saved both during principal photography and in post. And time is money, baby. You know all those behind-the-scenes clips with the actors in skin-tight suits and the dots? Performance capture is a popular technique which uses the performances of real actors as the basis for fully digitized characters.
Ah! Oh my God! Oh my God! This is amazing!
Capturing the detail and nuances of the talent's performance at that moment in time and converting it into a digital form. When performance capture is run with a real-time game engine solution, this is when virtual production really shines. On a separate but similar note, you can leverage volumetric capture to record a performance from every angle.
Okay, we're ready to go. Can you step onto the deck?
You can then drop that performance into any scene, whether it's a 2D plate or a virtual environment in a real-time game engine. Simulcam is one of the tools that comes in handy when visualizing the shots during pre-production or when in principal photography. Augmented reality is used to simulate the digital characters and settings that the filmmakers and showrunners have envisioned on set. This allows them to see what CG elements will look like in frame in real time, rather than waiting to see how it turns out in post. It's great for shot composition, actors' eyelines, and getting a sense on the day of what the final shot will look like. Not all virtual production methods involve creating an entire world or character. On-set virtual production can give you real-time results, such as using LEDs in order to capture interactive lighting effects like flickering fire, moving shadows, or reflections from the lights of a vehicle. The key here is that the lighting responds in real time to the environment of the scene.
So it should be all warmish, it's all fire-based lamps, basically.
So lighting scenarios, that's something as well. Let's say the sun is on this side, but the director changed their minds, so they want it to be on this side now. The VAD can go with the support of the volume control team. They can change the lighting and they can make all the adjustments necessary to achieve the final results and the expected results for the creative on the day.
The cool part is you can also shoot directly into the LED walls to capture the image in camera. The days of tedious, repetitive green screen background replacement are over. Or at least reduced. This has become the technique that has become most popular and has become synonymous with the term virtual production. But as you can see, virtual production encompasses several different techniques beyond filming an LED wall. Yeah, it's a lot, but stick with us and let's learn about how these tools can open up new possibilities and ways to bring your story to life.